Hey everybody out there in YouTube land, this is Jen, and you know what guys, I am so fucking happy right now. I am joyful, I am fucking like just on the happy train, because guess what guys, I got a new fucking couch cover, and isn't this fucking couch cover a fucking vibe? Like nothing could make me happier than this fucking couch cover. Oh, yeah, and I guess he's back too.
Yo.
So if you want to hear our very, very late thoughts on Evil Dead Rise, stick around.
I don't know if I've ever talked about it before, but I'm kind of an Evil Dead fan. I really like this franchise.
Really?
Yeah, I don't think I've ever mentioned that before whatsoever. But yeah, I like these movies a lot.
Gasp. You learn something about someone every day.
Yeah, I know. So I was incredibly excited for this one. Wanted to see it opening night, but...
didn't work out.
Yeah, long story short, did not work out to save a long story. But we finally got to see it right before it's about to hit VOD.
Last day that it was in the theater.
But hey, whatever.
And I really love the franchise, don't get me wrong, but it's not one of my all-time favorite
you
franchises.
Like the, you like,
I like it.
You like the movies, but it's never an all-time favorite for you.
Yeah, I love Bruce Campbell, chainsaws, and fucking tree rape. I mean, nothing will be better. Tree rape is in the top five. I mean, fucking tree rape, woohoo! So I was interested. I enjoyed this movie, but fair and honest reviews, right? I didn't love, there are other movies in this franchise that I like better, including the remake. Like, but that's not to say that this is a bad film. And one thing I really get from this movie is, man, the people behind the camera have so much love for this franchise. It's in such loving hands. And there are so many little homages and stuff. And like, I'm not even that, I probably missed a few because like, again, I'm not the massive fan Christian or some of you guys are, but I caught a lot of them and I saw you smiling at a few places.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just so loving, but how it handles it really well, because it doesn't shove it in your face. It's one of those things, if you know, you know, if you don't, we'll move on.
It's not stupid fan servicey. It's just little homages to the legacy that came before it. This movie, if I could describe this movie in one sentence, this movie is about building its own path for the franchise and carving its own identity in it, while still lovingly sending up and paying send up to everything that came before it. This movie
love letter.
Yeah, this is a love letter while still wanting to do something slightly fresh and new with the franchise, while still feeling like a proper Evil Dead movie.
Yeah, which is the way a remake should go, because at the one hand, you always want him to have love. You don't want people who like this is just a cash cow for him, and this does
you
have
don't want an Elm Street remake.
No, God, no, you do not want that. And this, I'm happy to say, isn't that. And I like our cast of characters, particularly one character, which we'll talk about in a minute. This is a very strong cast. I do have a couple issues, and it's probably not the issues you guys would think, but overall, this is a fun cast. It's a fun story. And there are a little, like I said, I think you liked it better than I did.
I did, yeah.
But there's a few problems, but overall, I had a good time. And there was one scene where we'll really get into it that I just had the biggest smile on my face. I was like, I'm here for this.
I had an ear grin for pretty much the entirety of this.
You did.
I was having a blast with it. It was such a fucking fun ride. And this is gonna might sound a little bit shitty towards the other movies. It's not. Evil Dead 2 is my favorite movie. Love this franchise. I love Ash. This is no shit towards them. The Evil Dead franchise always had a lot of personality, and Ash was always the centerpiece. Bruce Campbell brought so much. But Evil Dead had one major flaw throughout all of them. The remake kind of started to get past it with like Mia and her brother, but most of the rest of the cast weren't that interesting. What this movie does, unlike any other Evil Dead film, is it is a very strong character piece, and it is very character focused.
Yes.
We get to know this family unit very well. Sans one, sadly, but like we get enough of a vibe for them. We get most the other characters that are in the apartment building with them are just
body count.
Their body count. Of that's not a spoiler, of course. They're just there to die in glorious ways, and boy do they. And all the actors bring fucking killer performances to all their roles. Even the child, like I'm known for being very hard on child actors and kid characters in the movie. I liked her. She was fine. She wasn't my favorite character in the movie, and I bet I would have liked if we gave a little less focus to her and maybe to the other daughter. But like
she gave you a favorite scene of yours.
She was fine though. She was great. She worked fine. Like, a little kid in an Evil Dead movie sounds like a terrible idea. I was fine with it. It worked great. But this movie is very much about building that emotional backbone and getting you invested in this family. So you feel bad for them when all this carnage starts happening to them and tearing this family unit apart. It's very, and you feel for them. Like, everyone in this family unit, they're very believable. Like, while sadly the older sister gets kind of shafted in the development or focus side of things, you still feel bad for this family. They feel like a genuine, believable family unit.
Yes, they're
going through some tough shit, but they have a very strong bond, and it's believable.
The relationship between the two sisters, even though it doesn't spell out everything that in their backstory, you get that they have a complicated relationship. But there's love. At the end of the day, there's love, and they really do care about each other and stuff. And you really get that's very fleshed out. The kids, while I really liked them and found them fun, I found it a little lacking. Like, I wish they kind of dropped their stories about the middle of the movie.
They do kind of get shafted, which that might just be a thing with Evil Dead, because even I love Evil Dead 2 to death, favorite movie. Everyone in that movie's cast sans Ash, like his daughter fucking when she comes in, like you think okay she's gonna be kind of interesting and she's fine, but like she doesn't get a lot to do. The redneck couple, they don't get a lot to do. I love them, but they don't get a lot to do. You know, cast from the originals, Army of Darkness, and this has been an ongoing problem with any of them. All of Mia's friends sans her brother from the remake, and I guess 70s guy, but that's just because he has a very memorable silhouette and personality and shit. That is one of my two big problems with this movie. Is I really, especially our eldest sister, who's like a political activist, Bridget. She does not. Which also, I love that all of the characters are named after actresses and actors from that have worked in the Evil Dead franchise. I appreciated that.
It's a cute nod, but it doesn't shove it.
It's
in your
really
face.
Cute. It's really cute, and they're not obvious ones. Like nobody's named Bruce or Ted or anything in that. It's just they're side actors who were in Evil Dead movies. It's a great touch. But like particularly, yeah, Bridget really gets shafted. We get her talking about going to a political protest in the morning, and that's about the most we get for her for the rest of the movie, really. Same thing with Danny, the sole son of the family. Like, we get that he wants to be like a DJ or some sort of work in the music field and stuff. That he's very insecure about stuff and possibly being the reason why all of this is happening to his family, but don't get a lot with him. The youngest daughter gets a little bit more just because she's kind of the prime focus, but even then, the kids do kind of get shafted a little
bit. It's not about the kids.
It's not. It is very much about, one, it's very much about this carnage, but it's more so like it's about it, who cares? It's about the dynamic between the two sisters.
Yeah, it really is, and family, and also kind of motherhood, because basically,
ooh, yes.
Because these two sisters, you know, the one, she's a mother of three kids. Her husband recently left her, and I love that scene where the sister finds out, whoa, I brought this for your, oh. I love that. And then she tells the kids to go to the pizza parlor and Harrietta's Pizza. Again, really cute little touch. Very cute little touch. But then the other one, and she's, I love how in the movie, everybody who knows about her sister, the sister refers to her as a groupie.
Yeah, behind her back, everyone in the apartment building just goes, oh, you're the groupie one, because again, it gives into their backstory of like, okay, they're loving, but there's some weird animosity between the two of them inherently.
I can relate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can relate, because she's a sound technician. Well, I don't know if that's her.
She's a roadie. Our main character is a roadie, and then the other mother who gets possessed is, I think she's supposed to be a tattoo artist, and she's making the gun in the beginning.
Yeah,
I think she's supposed to be a tattoo artist.
She's some sort of artist and stuff, and they go in very different paths. And she and the one roadie kind of finds out that she's pregnant, and she's kind of coming to her sister, what the fuck do I do? Yeah. Do I have it to be a mother? And you can kind of tell that before the one sister kind of gets changed, she don't think she has it cut out for as a motherhood.
And you see that that really expand on. Like, yes, it's the Deadeye talking, but they can track through their fucking minds. They know what that person was thinking.
Yeah, and it's very good. But the kids, with the little bit of screen time we do get with the kids, they're really good. And, like, I like that the son just wants to have fucking the family to be okay, yeah. The money. He's not just doing it to be greedy. He's like, Mom could really use the money.
How do we get the fucking Necronomicon play this? He fucking jacks it from a fucking tomb that was under their apartment building because he's like, hey, this will probably sell for a lot. Is it? Look at this creepy, weird book with, like, fucking bone spines on the side of it. What the fuck's this about? I love this iteration of the Necronomicon. It's a lot more believable than it's done. Like, it's creepy looking and it's obviously evil, but a little bit more subtle and downplayed than the Necronomicon we're used to from the rest of the franchise. Also, I love, like, it's a continuity nightmare, but I do appreciate the fact, because Cronin has stated that in his mind, all of the movies are canon to this film, including the remake, so they make a point of saying, like, oh, this is one of three Necronomicons that exist in the world, giving an explanation for all the fucking shit, so somehow this is canon, every movie is canon, even though that makes no sense, but fuck it, I'm here for it, for the incredibly unlikely possibility, but hey, it's a pipe dream of maybe getting an Ash and Mia teaming up with the characters from this movie and another movie, that'd be cool. I know Bruce Campbell says he's retired for the most part, but that'd be cool.
Question, is this canon?
I don't know. I highly doubt it. Given the end of Ash vs. Evil Dead, I highly doubt that's canon.
I saw that, I'm like, wait a minute here, okay, yeah, get the movies, that's
yeah,
the
movies
film.
Are what's canon. Army of Darkness plus remake are canon to this film in Lee Cronin's mind. It's not a big important thing, but if you're a massive Evil Dead dork like me, you're gonna be like, wait, what?
But I do like how it does try to, you know, in a way, connect everything and make it all. And I like that we're inclusive with everything, because, you know, everybody, like,
yeah. There's loving homages
to everything.
Every Evil Dead thing. Especially to, which I, of course, appreciate, but makes
sense. I
think
most people
do. It makes sense, since Cronin said that's literally his favorite movie, so of course he's going to have preference. But, like, there's a great homage to the first film with one character turning into a Deadite that I love. There's a lot of love to the remake. There's a lot. There's some to Army. I think Army gets shafted the most, but there's a few ones here and there.
There is. And of course, there's one of my favorite scenes where we kind of get a recreation of Tree Rape. It's not as good as Tree Rape,
but it's a great homage. Plus, I love the fact that if you notice, her tattoos are ivy wrapping around her arms.
I did notice that.
Yeah, I was like, that's such a great feel. Like, there's so many great little bits in this.
Yeah, and when they find these pictures with the book that it's Ted Raimi.
Yeah, there's just a random Ted Raimi as a priest, and I want spoil how, but there is a Campbell cameo. It's just voiceover, which I actually prefer, because that's, like, my biggest problem with the remake is his little cameo.
But I love his little cameo!
I love it, but it feels like that movie wanted to have its own personality separate from the rest of the franchise, and the last second, they kind of tried to drag it back in. Like, hey, that was great, but you remember how great the... And yes, I do remember how great the other Evil Dead movies are, but, like, I like this because it was its own thing separate from those movies, paying a loving homage to it. Like, I like that it's just, this time Campbell's just a voice cameo.
And what he says is so funny.
It's so great. And given the fact of, like, okay, Army of Darkness is canon to this, does that mean the Army of Darkness comics are canon where Ash time travels? So maybe that just straight up is Ash's voice.
It could very well be. One thing, though, and this is a minor criticism that I do think the remake did better. Technically, this movie is the bloodiest.
1,700 gallons of fake blood.
But
most of it's in one scene,
in
though.
An elevator scene. Very Sam's The Shining kind of thing. But I think the remake did do the blood and gore better. And if you're someone like me, and I know not everyone, I know you probably aren't, but if you love the blood and gore like I do, I'm here more for the remake. That's one of the reasons why the remake.
Pound for pound, the remake's way more nasty,
yes,
violent, and mean.
Yes.
With its kills. And
I'm here for it.
Yeah, like, this movie does have the most blood in any of the movies. But it's mostly just for one single thing. Otherwise, it's about on par with the first film in its level of, like, blood and violence. It's there, but it's not, it's a little bit more pulled back than, say, the remake or even Evil Dead 2 or Army of Darkness at points.
But where it lacks in blood, where it really goes to the Evil Deadness, is this movie's humor.
Oh my
humor.
God,
this humor
fucking,
is funny.
This Deadite is so, like, that's the thing that I always, like, I always have loved about the fucking Deadite. Evil Dead movies, because I've talked about before, people might have wondered, like I've said, I'm not big into possession movies, yet I love Evil Dead. It's because the Deadites have so much personality, and they're such assholes. That's what I've loved about them compared to most other possession stories, is that the demons are assholes and will fuck with you constantly.
Just because.
In various different ways, because it's fun to them. I love that. And this one, more so than I think any other, is the Deadite is such an asshole. And the actress playing it, fucking hats off to her. She gives a killer performance when once she's possessed. It is amazing. She brings so many great little mannerisms to it that just work so well.
Because she is not just reciting dialogue, people. It's a very
incredibly physical.
And I believe she was a contortionist and stuff, and you can really see there are some scenes where she has to do her body and stuff, and but, it's really good.
But where she signs aren't those grandiose contortionist moments, it's the little face movement.
Yes!
I was telling you, possibly my favorite moment of the entire movie is there's a bit where they have her out, got her out of the apartment, they got her barricaded out, and she's talking to the youngest daughter through the peephole, and just, and just like, oh no, honey, I'm okay, I'm
Daddy's here.
Daddy's here and stuff and like
we're
that.
We're gonna be a family.
And like, obviously the audience was like, okay, no, that's fucking bullshit.
Manipulation.
Yeah, it's incredibly manipulative. But since it's a little 8-year-old child, she wants to believe it. So she's like, okay, I'll believe you, mommy. You get a split second shot
of
the actress's face, like, or just a slight expression. She was like, wait, really? That worked? Oh my god, you're so stupid. You are such a moron, child. That fucking worked? That never works. Oh my god, this is great. I love it. There's so many little moments like that throughout the movie. The mother is the main one, but the other characters, once they get possessed and once we get more Deadites going into this, they also bring a lot to it, but the mother is the fucking
standout out of it.
She is what sells this movie so hardcore. Everyone in this cast is great. Lee Cronin's direction's great. Writing's great. A lot of stuff's great. There's problems, which I won't talk about, but like, that is the, if there's one thing that just sells this movie above any of the other movies. Yeah, like, this is probably my second to least favorite one after Army of Darkness.
Which is weird, considering how much you're sucking its dick.
Yeah, like, if there's one thing I will say this movie does better than any other one, is this fucking Deadite. Not the humor, it's this fucking Deadite.
Gotcha.
This actress is fucking phenomenal, she is great, I love her, and this is my favorite Deadite out of any of the movies. She's fantastic.
Now, I want to talk about this, but especially for me, because I'm old, as you love pointing out, I'm old, and like, nothing, I think, for some of us fans who were there, well, you can't touch first two Evil Deads, and so for some people, even Army of Darkness, trilogy.
I don't hate Army of Darkness, it's easily my least favorite of the franchise, but I still really like Army of Darkness, of course.
Yeah, and so like, there's that nostalgic thing with me. Since you're a younger fan, you said you could see this kind of going up, but would it ever touch?
I'll talk about this more when we do our ranking at the end of the video, but like, give this movie some time. Like, yes, it's my second to least favorite behind Army of Darkness. I still love the fuck out of this movie. I had a phenomenal time at the theater watching it. I had a blast with it, and I could see, as time goes on, this movie could kind of join the first film and the remake for like in a three-way tie battle to the death for my second favorite of the franchise, because like, I really could see this movie growing on me a lot as time goes on and more subsequent rewatches. This is a fun-ass movie.
Yeah, but that's another thing. While it does deal with a motherhood and some serious subjects, it's still
it's
a fun. At the end of the day, it's
an Evil Dead movie. Let's see some blood and some fucking guts.
And I also just love the shotguns. Just the little touches with the shotguns.
Yeah.
And I have to talk, I'm a cliche, standardized bitch, and I'm not gonna pretend I'm anything else. But God, I loved how, and I y'all know it's coming. Dead by Dawn! And it's so fucking, and I was sitting, and we had other people in the theater, but I didn't fucking care.
We were giggling like fucking schoolgirls.
We were and I was chatting with the movie. I was like, oh, this is so much fun. And this is where I don't understand. I've heard some people go, it's not and it's really a lot of fun. It's a popcorn movie, and I don't mean that in a bad way.
Okay.
But it's a popcorn movie.
Okay, that's the thing, because I remember, I didn't watch any reviews or any shit. I didn't get any news or anything on this movie. But I did get an idea of the reception this movie was getting. Of a lot of people were like, I like, and this is no hate if this is you. I'm not talking about anyone specifically. This is no hate if you felt this way. But I heard the consistent consensus was, this is good, but it doesn't feel quite like an Evil Dead movie. Or I was a little let down and stuff. It's not it is an Evil Dead movie. It's just trying to do something slightly different. Because basically, I love them. But all of them, sans Army of Darkness, which is kind of its own thing, all of them, three of these fucking movies are basically interchangeable. Like,
yeah.
the remake and then one and two are basically interchangeable with
each
other. Well,
one and two, basically two
is a remake. Two is a remake of one. It's an expansion on one, but it's also a remake of one.
Yeah, basically.
Army of Darkness is off doing its own thing, but like, for
the remake is balls to the walls.
And the remake is the first film up to fucking 20.
Yeah, on crack.
Yeah, this movie is still doing that. It is still, at the end of the day, and I'll come back to this, at the end of the day, it is still basically that formula of, even though we're in an apartment building, it's basically just a cabin in the woods story.
Yes.
But, it's like I said earlier, the thing that sets this apart from the other movies and gives it its own different, distinct feel from them is the fact that it's trying to tackle a little bit, like, not a super heavy theme or anything, but it's injecting it in there, and it's trying to be a little bit more character-focused for its entire cast. Yes, Evil Dead has always been, Ash has always been the centerpiece and the prime character that we follow, but the rest of the side cast that Ash gets along with, sans maybe Ash versus, they mostly are superfluous characters that are just there to die, which this movie has, but we have a lot wider cast of characters that we follow and we want to expand on and we want to get the audience invested in. The remake tried that, but really, even Mia's brother, like, he's fine, but he's not that compelling. Mia is the only super duper interesting character out of the remake.
Yeah, but then again, these movies are very different.
They're all doing very different things. That's what I mean. This movie is lovingly setting up and homaging everything that came before in all forms of the franchise, but also, like,
I want to do my own thing.
Want to take a slightly different path, path that may connect back to that, to the path that the rest of the franchise was on at a few points, but mostly it's on its own journey that it's going down and wants to see where that leads. It's slightly different. It's the same, it's just slightly different. So, like, if you, for whatever reason, are still at this point of the video, haven't watched it and want to check it out when it hits VOD in a couple days, know going in, don't expect Evil, like, expect Evil Dead.
But don't expect Evil Dead.
But expect something slightly different. Also, don't expect Demons 2, because I know everyone made that joke of, oh my god, it's people possessing a department building. That is my other big problem.
Yeah, I was gonna get into that.
For a movie that's like this big thing, is like the whole marketing campaign was like, we're out of the woods, we're in the city, we're in an urban setting, we're setting an
apartment building.
We do not utilize our apartment building setting that much, because for the most part, we're basically confined to one single floor of the apartment building. Due to reasons, we can't really get off of that one floor for most of the movie. So it feels very hollow and just basically feels like they're in a fucking giant cabin at the end of the day.
Yeah, that was one thing I was thinking when I heard this announced, okay, so are we going to do a poll? And I'm very in the minority here, but I fucking love Poltergeist 3, low-key.
It's probably
my favorite of that franchise. I'm weird, but I thought we were going to be doing like that. Poltergeist 3, whether you love it or hate the movie, says does it better.
It utilizes the apartment building setting more so. Candyman 2022.
Yes.
Original Candyman.
Yeah.
Even like Demons 2. Like, they all are way more. If you want something like that, that is my big, only other big problem besides I would have liked a little bit more focus for some of the characters. Is we don't utilize the setting as to the fullest as I feel like we could have, but I can also see time constraints. Also, the thing that I honestly forgot about because it's been so long, this was supposed to be a streaming movie. So
yes,
they probably didn't have the budget to do that. It was already filmed and finished when they decided to give it a theatrical release. So this was supposed to be a lot more medium-sized budget, and then it got so much positive representation that they decided to put it out in theaters. So, like, I get reminding myself of that, I can see, yeah, okay, it's not that big of a deal at the end of the day, but I would have really liked to see us use that apartment building setting just a little bit more.
But even our big biggest problem, or at least I can't speak for you, but for me, even the ones that are a little bit more problematic, this movie is still fun. At the end of the day, it's a little different from, it's very much like Christian said, it is an Evil Dead movie, but it's also trying to do its own thing. It's a fun popcorn movie, and like if you have, I feel like all massive Evil Dead fans, unless you were stuck in Texas somewhere and had a YouTube channel and couldn't get to the theater for a while. Everybody, you know, has already gone into the theater and seen it, but if you've been on the fence and heard some things, if you have any sort of fondness, maybe even less than some people, you definitely should check it out.
You don't have to be as much of a nut as I am to own, like, 70 copies of these movies. This isn't even all of them that I own.
No, it's not. I can attest to that. But for me personally, yes, there's a few nitpicks, there's a couple of problems, but overall, it's fun. And you gotta remember, people, most of us have lived with the Evil Dead movies for a very long time, so of course we're gonna hold those up in higher nostalgia, but this is not a cash grab. It was made with love. What more do you guys want? You have a great cast, you have great people behind the camera. It's a fun, enjoyable movie, and this is coming from someone who's not a massive fan like you are.
It's a bigger and more beautiful and loving send-up to it than most other recent horror franchises have gotten. Like, most other major horror franchises for their recent entries haven't gotten this level of love and admiration put into them.
Whatever do you mean?
No idea. I don't even know what posters I'm going to insert in this segment just yet. I have an idea, but, you know, this movie was made by massive Evil Dead nerds, and that's both
it's very obvious.
It's both a great thing and a bad thing, but the thing I like is the remake was also made by Freddy Alvarez is an Evil Dead dork.
Yes.
But so is Lee Cronin, but he's an Evil Dead dork in a slightly different way than Freddy Alvarez is. And yeah. I think that's really refreshing, and it shows. Like, it's cool to see this franchise go in a slightly different direction, but still, at the end of the day, it feels like home. It still feels like home.
I don't know, Sparky, you know, it really pissed me off. I mean, how fucking dare they? We're following a fucking woman, and she has a... I mean, we can't... That dumb bitch probably doesn't even know how to use that shotgun. But whatever you use to stream your movies with, watch it on a Friday night, have a good time, watch it with friends, watch it with someone you love, and you're not, I don't think you're gonna go, man, I just wasted my fucking time.
No, that's the thing, like, if you haven't seen it for whatever reason, check it out when it hits VOD.
Yeah, definitely check it out.
And if you saw it in theaters and were kind of underwhelmed, maybe give it some time and then revisit it. This is what I almost, like, kind of feel like.
People jump the gun.
Kind of like what happened to the remake. I see this having the same fate as the remake of, it was very mixed kind of negative reception when it came out, but as time gone on, people really warmed up to it. I kind of see like this, that's the same thing that's going to happen to this movie. I think this movie's going to have a pretty decent fan base and following as the years go on, and I definitely can say I was there from the start. I am an Evil Dead Rise hipster. I like the fuck out of this movie. I give it a positive. It has a few issues. There's some stuff I would have liked to do a little bit differently, but overall, I had a fucking blast of a time, and sometimes that's all I can ask for from a movie, and it gave me a really good time.
Yeah, and it just took you away from the current state of the world, so that's always a good thing. I give it a B+. It's a good time. It's not my favorite of the franchise, but it is a good time. Speaking of our favorites in the franchise, we're gonna tack this on, guys, because I know you guys are sitting on the edge of their seats. I wonder what their ranking is, and we're not gonna do two videos.
No, we're not doing two separate
we're too
videos.
Lazy.
Here's mine. Army of Darkness, this, and then one in the remake are battling it out for second place. But like I said in the video, I could kind of see this movie kind of joining those three as time goes on, and then two's my favorite by far. And I love Ash vs. Evil Dead. It's a great fucking series. I don't know where it'd fit in, but I love it. It's a great show.
I get it. For me, I'm a little bit of a copycat with Christian Bale. Well, not completely, but Army of Darkness definitely goes at the bottom. And I don't hate that movie. It's just for me, the rewatchability's a little lower personally for me. You guys know I'm not so much on the comedy. I'm real hard with the comedy, and that's like I'm praising the comedy for the one.
Like, it pushes it.
Not my kind of comedy.
Yeah, it's a little too. That one is a little
Three
too,
Stooges.
Yeah, they always have been, but that one's a little. Somebody should have pulled. And I know a lot of people that's their favorite. But like that one, I feel like Raimi should have been pulled back just a tiny, tiny bit.
Just a bit. So Army of Darkness is my number 5. My number 4 is Evil Dead Rise. But I got no hate to that one because I really like it. And while I don't think it will go up super. I could see it trading places and maybe going up a spot or two given some time.
This is one even you'll revisit once in a while, I feel, if I'm watching.
Yeah, I really will. I really definitely will. And then the actually, surprisingly, I'm gonna say that okay, maybe I'm not gonna go that far. The remake would be, but the remake has gone up for me. I was kind of a naysayer.
That's something, yeah, you never liked the remake for the longest time.
Blame Marty. Anything you want, like that. No, Marty and I have done some discussions on it, and it's not because he's my boyfriend and I want to bang him, which I do, but it's because Marty did make some points, and you did too. It's just, I had to rewatch it, and I'm like, for me, it is sort of tailor-made for me, because I am someone who loves the violence.
It is easily the most violent and mean spirit out of the evil.
Which is sort of my thing.
Yeah, like, that was what that movie was absolutely going for.
Yeah, and I think in maybe a year or two, it might climb up, but right now, we're gonna go with number three, and then number two is number two, and then of course my darling is the first one.
You're an Evil Dead boomer.
I'm an Evil Dead boomer, and also, you know, it doesn't hurt tree rape.
Tree rape.
I fucking love, like, nothing will ever charm me as much as fucking tree rape. My God, I dressed up as a tree for an Evil Dead stream. I dressed up as the tree of rape.
Yeah,
wee!
That was a thing. Maybe.
That's a thing I did. So, like, I love all these movies, but again, and I think that's interesting with your, I'll at least admit it, while I love new horror, there are some that's just because of nostalgia and when I saw them as a child. And while, like I said, Evil Dead doesn't mean as much to me as Christian, I do remember the first time I saw Evil Dead, I'm like, this is fucking cool.
Yeah.
Like, I dig this. So I'm always going to have a preference, and I don't think anything will ever touch those movies.
No. This was never going to be part two. It's my favorite movie for a very strong reason. That's never going to change. And I love the fuck out of one in the remake, too. So,
and Tree Rape.
And yeah, I love the fuck out of these movies. So this was a losing. This movie was probably always gonna land here. But like I said, I could, give me some time, I could see myself in a couple years lumping this with part one in the remake as being a three-way tie of, like, my second favorite of the franchise. I love all these movies. I'm an Evil Dead dork at heart.
Yay, three! I didn't hear any of that after three-way. Yay, three-way!
Right on. Well,
so with all that, and oh my God, I'm so happy you're back. I am. I was just teasing at the bang, but I was so happy he's back. He's not going anywhere. You're not going anywhere. You're not going anywhere. I'm gonna
that
keep
seems
it.
Like
I keep. I'm gonna keep them chained to something.
That seems like
you
a
can't be chained to my bed because Marty's already chained to my bed, but somewhere, and you're my son, so that'd be creepy. But welcome back, darling.
Goodbye.
So with all that out of the way, just a quick, we'll probably do an update, a video, because we got to talk about a few things, so we might do an update video, but for all you people that are wondering, our next big project is going to be a little corny, shall we say. We haven't forgotten about it, and then we'll catch up with a lot of other stuff, but don't you worry, we're going to get a little corny here on the grave. We're going to spread some corn over the tombstone and go, yee-haw! Partners! Fucking yee-hoorah!
That every year we add new lore to the channel. This year's lore is this is actually all filmed inside of a mausoleum. Like, the name is very little. We're literally in a graveyard. This may look like a room in a house. We just have it really nice. It's actually a room in a mausoleum.
Yeah.
Every year we gotta add a sprinkle, a little bit extra Ginger Views lore.
Yeah, we do. We have to spread some more corn onto ye pastures of the internet. Ooh, that Marty's rubbing off on me. Yay, I'm like, I'm a worder. I do words.
Weren't we talking about Evil Dead?
So with all that out of the way, boos and ghouls, I'll say what I always say. We wish you a good day, a good evening, and in the meantime, keep watching and talking horror. Bye!